Okay, everyone, welcome back to CBD Yoga and Fitness. My name is Mike, and thank you all so much for joining me today. This is the first video in our Yin Yoga series, and I'm super excited to share this series with you all. For me personally, Yin Yoga is my favorite type of yoga, as well as my favorite type of yoga to teach. And in this video, we're going to be doing a short and sweet, gentle Yin Yoga video that is great for beginners and yogis of all levels. So when you're ready, roll your mat and let's get started. Okay, everyone, so we're gonna begin this nice and short Yin Yoga video coming into a child's pose. So bringing the knees as wide as the mat and the big toes to touch. We're only going to be doing five poses in this sequence. So it's going to be nice and short, nice and gentle. And in the child's pose, let's extend our arms out long here and feel free to rest your forehead in the mat. And whenever I do Yin Yoga, one of my favorite breathing techniques is to inhale for a count of 6 seconds. And holding just briefly at the top of the inhale for like a second or two, and then exhale for 6 seconds and holding it at the bottom for a second or two. So by all means, feel free to practice that breathing technique. And try and sink a little deeper into the pose with each exhale. On your next exhale, let's slowly move forward, coming onto our bellies and coming into a Sphinx pose. So stacking the elbows underneath the shoulders, forearms and the hands out in front of you. And you can keep your core just slightly engaged here, and you can keep your gaze down, opening up the heart. Coming back to your breath. Thank you. exhale here. Let's slowly, mindfully make our way up into a brief downward facing dog. Now from here, let's bring our right knee behind our right wrist, keeping our right foot flexed, extending that left leg out long, coming into a nice pigeon pose. So option to stay here with your hands rooted in the mat, sitting up tall, or you can also come on down to the forearms, and even come down a little bit further, resting the forehead in the mat. If you have a block here, you can feel free to rest it underneath the right glute. As always, coming back to your breath. On your next exhale, slowly, mindfully release and come back up into another downward facing dog. Feel free to pillow up the feet here if that feels nice. And then from here, bring that left knee behind the left wrist, keeping that left foot flexed, walking that right leg out long. And again, finding your variation on this side, either hands in the mat, sitting up tall, or coming onto the forearms or the forehead. And again, feel free to place that block underneath the left glute here. And on your next exhale, slowly release. From here, we'll make our way to a seat with the soles of the feet together, coming into a butterfly pose. An awesome hip opener here, so feel free to just rest your hands on your feet and sit up nice and tall if this is enough for you, or you can take it one step further by walking the hands out a little bit. Such a great hip opener. Continue to breathe. Next exhale, mindfully release. From here, we'll make our way onto our backs, coming into final Shavasana. Take up some space here. Just notice how you feel now. I know for me personally, I can just never get enough of Yin Yoga. My opinion, it's one of the best kept secrets in yoga. I encourage you to stay here in Shavasana for as long as you like, reaping the benefits of this sequence. If you haven't already, be sure to like and subscribe, and make sure to leave a comment down below if you like this video. From here, let's bring our hands up to our third eye. The light in me honors and bows to the light in all of you. Thank you so much. Namaste.